This is going to be fun, man. It's going to be another good match here.
This guy's a middleweight?
Yes, actually, he weighed in the heaviest.
My God.
Dave was the shortest and weighed in the heaviest. Good guy, man. Strong. Very strong. Whoa. Lifelong martial artist, this guy. Lifelong martial artist. Over 20 years in martial arts. Wrestling.
He's definitely the kid you question at Pee Wee Way.
This is going to be a great match. And the fact that two completely different body types. You have one tall and lanky. You have one short, stocky, strong Dave Elias. Steve Wilson, very tall and lanky. So we'll see how this plays. See if one plays that size or the other one plays the strength. You know, in the last one, the one Selecki took, it was purely showed you what jiu-jitsu is about, how it's the smaller man being able to defend himself against a larger, stronger opponent. Yeah, now with that in mind, in this one, you are going to see these matches today, all these matches, these guys are very technical grapplers, as you saw already. That's what's going to make this all these matches, man, a good time. So, yeah, we got David Elias, Steve Wilson.
And out of the red corner, we have Steve Wilson out of Dennis Fight Camps in Hamilton. Referee for this bout is going to be Josh Saber.
All right, getting this one on the way. All right, both guys again, the feel now process again. Again, Dave Elias does have a wrestling background, takes that shot, goes to that single leg, sprawled out by Steve Wilson. Dave's not giving up on a takedown yet. Looks like he might try to sit through on this. I believe Steve might be looking for a choke called a Peruvian necktie if he steps his legs over top. But Dave's doing a real good job of keeping them hands busy, not letting them lock them hands up. Defend the neck first, man. Again, still in like a front headlock type position, both guys on their knees. Dave had the failed shot. Good, right back up to the feet. Good job defending. Right back up by Elias. Steve Wilson got him pressed up against the ropes. Elias trying to throw his arm over for a guillotine. Gets his back off the ropes. Back into the middle. Good. Wilson keeping the double unders. Oh. Elias tried to pull that guard. Tried to pull guard and look for a tominagi or a sacrifice throw type sweep. Ends up on the bottom in half guard. Steve Wilson looking for a key lock here. Dave Elias defends perfectly, puts the hands on, pushes his arm away. But that lets Steve Wilson move into that side control position. A little more than halfway through the round. Wilson on top. Side control position. Looks like he keeps trying to work a key lock or trying to move his head in almost like he's trying for a head and arm. Elias doing a good job of keeping his forearm right on the side of his head, man, just to keep him away.
Now, Wilson has
Wilson
a...
Wilson right over dead mount position. Bridge by Elias, can't get him over. So now Wilson moves into that mount position. It looks like he might be looking again for a head and arm triangle.
You know, Wilson seems to have, like, a height advantage.
Wilson's definitely the tallest guy in the competition, which definitely doesn't hurt. Makes it a little easier to lock up triangles, things like that.
It does.
Having the long limbs, in my opinion, does make things a little easier to get out of. When your limbs are that long, it gives you a little more space to come out of things like triangles. That's my opinion, anyway. Wilson on top, still looking for a key lock. Elias keeps exploding. He's really got to trap an arm when he explodes, though, because he's leaving that arm out there where he can stop the actual reversal from happening. Wilson's really trying to work this key lock.
10 seconds. Time.
All right. First round's over. Be interested to see how these guys come out next round. Let's see what Elias. Be interesting to see what Elias comes out to do different. And see if Wilson does anything different or keeps the same game plan. Let Elias shoot. And he counters. We'll see. I expect Elias to be trying to come out and get into that top position quick, so he's probably going to be looking for the takedown. He had a real good attempt at that Tominagi throw. He just didn't get that foot up, didn't get that sweep off enough. Round two underway. Good. Elias coming right in, trying to get that inside control. Again, Wilson kind of staying back on his heels. Again, I think he wants Elias to shoot, is what it seems like. Hanging heavy on that head, trying to snap him down. Backed into the corner. Wilson's got him backed into the corner. Elias goes right for that guillotine, man. Makes it back out of it. Going for a bear hug takedown and trip. Right to mount. So Wilson gets that bear hug, uses that for a trip, goes right to mount, and Elias does a good job getting right back to half guard. See how Wilson uses that shoulder to turn his head the other way. Really makes it difficult for him to turn his hips in where he needs to get back to a guard position. So Wilson's doing a good job being strong, heavy on top. So again, what Elias really wants to do here is he really needs to get himself into a better position. He doesn't want to be flat on his back here. He definitely wants to get up on his side, get up onto his shoulder, to get back to a guard. What he's trying to do is he's trying to roll him one way and then switch to the other, which he just did. Really like to see him try to get back to a full guard here halfway through the second round. Again, Wilson on top, half guard. He keeps looking for a key lock, man. He does have it locked up there. Elias, great job of defending him, man. Pulls that arm out. That looked like he was ready to get a... ready to get really tight, really quick too.
I think his body size is playing a definite role.
Definitely.
He just can't get anything going.
He's long, and when he's long like that, he can anchor under the head and control his arms from his far side arm. He can control his left arm with his right arm because his arm is so long, anchoring under the head, and can still grab the arm. Makes it difficult. I mean, it definitely makes it difficult. We got under a minute left. We have about 50 seconds left in this second round. Good. Elias comes out that back door, and he's on top now. He's been waiting for this. Wilson reverses the position right away. But Dave Elias still has that key lock. Don't let it go. Don't let it go, man. He should crank that thing out. He should pull with everything he's got, man, to get that out right now. Got less than 30 seconds left in the round. He lets go of it right back into the half guard position. Wilson looking to take the back. Coming to an end of this round. Elias looks like he'll be safe through this round. Time. Wow. And that's the end of the second. That's the end of the second. So this is the first one. We're going to be going to a third. Elias definitely got some. Definitely got to get on top there for a second. In a scramble like that, it's just so difficult. You know what I mean? You're sweating. Just to get in that top position and try to hold somebody long like that down is just so difficult when you're sweaty. That when he got to that top position, just had a hard time holding on to it. Locked in that Kimura. Just wasn't able to finish. Wilson did a really good job of defending it.
Now, I would imagine. Watching the fight, I mean, I guess we would say Wilson's ahead
Wilson's
now.
Definitely. I would say Wilson's ahead.
So,
yeah. So Elias needs to finish in this round.
He needs to finish it all.
Finish him.
Right.
All right, round three underway. Let's see who's going to come out aggressive here. Both guys seem to have plenty of gas left in the tank, so should be entertaining. Good. Elias hanging heavy on the head. Good. Both guys just fight for inside control, looking for the takedown. Just go ahead and stand down a little bit, Steve. Good, pushing him through the ropes there. Josh doing a good job trying to keep him inside. Wilson going for that bear hug again, man. He does what he does really well, man, is he gets that grip right by the kidneys. And when he sucks it in, man, it's painful and it's hard to it's really hard to defend once your back starts going backwards like that. Elias rolls to his stomach. Wilson goes to take his back. He's got both arms under. He's looking for the rear naked choke. They're right at the ropes. Don't know if they'll be reset if they go any further, but they're close to rolling out. He's got that back, both hooks in. We got Elias go tap, rear naked choke. Another entertaining match, man. Another really entertaining match.
All right, guys.
Wilson moving on. Wilson moving on to the semifinals. And he'll get the winner of Michael Padilla and Rob Mudrack.